Hey guys, it's Wednesday. Welcome back to the vlog. We have an awesome new one for you today. We're gonna talk about the monarchs. We had lots of questions after last week's Trojan videos about the monarch project, because we talked about Trojan having some similarities to monarch. Of course, Trojan is just an incomplete dominant, and monarch is a wicked, wicked cool recessive. So let's jump in and talk about the monarchs, how they're different than Trojans, how they're different than ultramels, then look at some of the crazy babies we just made. So our best monarch girl is this beautiful, beautiful mom to the clutch, actually. And she has the very best color. We actually showed a little video of her this past week on our Trojan video, just as a comparison between Trojan and the Monarch. But the Monarch really, hands down, just blows away almost every other albino type. And I say it's an albino type, it has dark eyes. It doesn't have the pink or the colored eyes of like the caramels or the lavenders or the regular albinos. So it's different, but it's also very, very similar in a way, because it has that same color palette compared to the caramels and the ultramels, etc. So definitely different. In my mind, this is my very favorite one because of just those deep, deep dark mahogany colors on it. It's absolutely gorgeous. Those colors to me are the perfect blend of just really, really catches my eye. So we have a almost toffee color and then a deep maroon kind of in between. Now they don't start like this. We're gonna look in the babies, you see they start out much brighter colored and they can turn into this kind of the deeper adult colors. But one question we always get, and we got it after last week's video, is what is the difference color-wise between the ultramel and the monarch as adults? So let's go look at an ultramel compared to this. Okay, so here is the same monarch girl next to a beautiful adult ultramel, and you see how different their colors are. A lot of people come in and they say they like the ultramels more. Maybe it's just because I've had ultramels for so many years and monarchs are new, you know, unique look for me. I love those, the monarch look. So, you know, I'm still working my ultramel projects. I made some really cool ultramels this year and I'm gonna keep working on them for sure, keep pushing them forward. We have some awesome ultramel clowns and pieds and all that. But long term, I wanna see all those same combos with the monarch. I'm just really excited about this project. All right, so before we look at those babies, look at mom and dad together. So this is, of course, is the mom, the monarch girl. And this is a male that I made a few years ago. This is yellow belly spot nose, double het monarch clown. So we were starting that clown monarch project. So these babies, of course, she's not het clown. So these babies are gonna be, they're monarchs, they're 50% het clown. And it's just the start of a project. He's a really awesome boy. I love his color. I think this is gonna look insane as a monarch, but we get a little taste of it when we check out these babies now. So we managed to get great odds. We got three insane monarch babies out of it. So the first one is a spot nose. Let's check it out here down next to its siblings. We'll talk about what these other two are in a second. So this is a spot nose monarch. And I don't think it's the first, because I have an awesome customer and friend who just made some spot nose and leopard monarchs. In fact, we're gonna show you one of those in a little bit. Absolutely incredible. Really, really pretty, beautiful, beautiful. Just the color of them and just the intensity of the color as a baby is so close to the adults when she starts adding in some of these darker, high contrast mutations. Now these two, you can see they also have insane color. They are yellow belly. Then just for comparison, here is the non-monarch version. So this is yellow belly het monarch, and these are yellow belly monarchs. It's a good chance to kind of talk about what yellow belly is. If you look at the crazy checkering on the sides of these bellies, that's your typical yellow belly look. They're extremely variable. No two of them look alike. They're probably one of the most variable mutations, but generally speaking, you want that checkering on the sides, mostly white belly, but you can have a little bit of yellow and colors into it. And then you have typically is these flames, these little kind of red or white markings coming up in the sides. You call these flames where you have kind of a burnout of color coming up into the black. So these are kind of red, sometimes they're more white. One, two, three, four, five, six, they have flames all the way down the snake, and that is a kind of a typical yellow belly look. If you're wondering about yellow belly, we get lots of questions about how to see a yellow belly from a normal. Plus they tend to have higher contrast, a little bit more blacks and everything. I love the look of the monarchs next to the normal. You can see exactly how different that color is. It's amazing. Okay, so I wanted to end the video by showing this awesome leopard monarch, and I did get this from the other gentleman, Eric Griffin. He sold me this amazing, amazing animal, and it's an amazing example too. Cool thing is he produces from some of the animals I sold him a few years back, so this is another example of getting a grandbaby right back into the collection. And so this one is also 50% het clown. So leopard monarch, 50% het clown, a beautiful boy, and I look forward to trying to prove him to be het clown and just using him for some awesome monarch projects in the future. I love just how bright the color is, and the pattern is just Of course, it's a typical leopard pattern, but the contrast between, I don't know, how do you even explain those colors, really, honestly? It's like a deep maroon with a orangey tan, and it's just a really cool contrast. Look forward to working with this guy a little bit more in the future. Let me show you a regular leopard, just side by side. Okay, pulling in a regular leopard here just for comparison. This thing is so tiny by comparison. This thing has only had one meal, and this one's had at least two, right? It's definitely a well-fed boy. So you see the color difference between the regular leopard and the pattern difference too. Leopards are extremely variable as well, but they all have that kind of wild dark browns and blacks mixed in, just a very, very weird, non-typical pattern. Cool little head stamp on them too. But yeah, you have leopard versus leopard monarch. Awesome, thank you so much, Eric, for trusting me with this awesome boy. And I look forward to doing great things with them, and best of luck on your projects as well. All right, that's it, guys. Thanks so much. Hope you enjoyed the Monarch project. Real fast, let's talk about one of the big questions about that project is it compatible with Ultramel? So Monarch came out long after Ultramel, long after Caramel. Caramel was the first kind of in this series of this T-plus melanistic albino type animal. And I think we have a lot to learn about how these are actually genetically linked, if they are at all. So we know that Caramel and Ultramel are not compatible. There's indications that Ultramel and Monarch are also not compatible, which I don't think they are. They're very different looking. But kind of like our previous video, where we talked about how IDs are very difficult, this really comes down to you have to kind of do it in a scientific way and repeat it several times to know 100% each way. So we'll find out, and if I ever find out, I'll definitely bring you that information when I do. Hope you guys enjoyed that video. Thanks so much for watching. We have something really special to bring you on Friday's vlog, so make sure you tune in on Friday. Like and subscribe, and we'll see you then.